This is the one everyone will be talking about, the West Coast Eagles versus Frio at Perth Stadium. The details, West Coast won 142-84, but they won't be talking about the win or the margin. They'll be talking about this, the brain fade from Andrew Gaff that has left Andrew Brayshaw in hospital with a suspected broken jaw.
Yes, you are right, and brain fade is the way to put it, because this is a guy who, in 175 games of football, has never been suspended. It's completely uncharacteristic of him. You can see him on the bench there. He was completely shaken up. He couldn't believe what he's done. Adam Simpson, the coach, was down there just trying to focus him back on the game. It was sickening. As you can see here in the last quarter, the Frio players weren't happy. They went after him. It probably wasn't the smartest move having him on the field, because he really became a victim. But there's going to be some huge implications of this. This is a guy who's out of contract. There's been so much talk about whether he's going to stay at that footy club. He's one of the guys that's been a short price runner to win the Brownlow. Well, that's out now. This club's about to play finals football. They've already lost Nick Natanui, and this is their top midfielder, and he probably won't play a final now for the footy club.
Do you know if anything happened in the lead-up to that incident, Gibber?
I don't know. I don't know if he was provoked, but as I said, it's just so uncharacteristic of him that, me and a lot of people in the footy world were really stunned.
So if that's graded as intentional high contact, high impact, it's straight to the tribunal and a minimum of 3 weeks. If he gets 6 weeks, if you double that, he misses the grand final if they make it. So what are we looking at precedent here? We're looking Thomas Bugg on Callum Mills last year for 6 weeks?
Well, you have to. This was the one last year, as you can see there. A left hook for me, Loz, I don't know what you think. I don't think that's even as strong as the one that Gaff threw today.
No, I think Gaff's is a lot worse. He will be lucky to play again this season, Gaff. It just wasn't a good look. Look, I know he's remorseful and regrets his actions, and he's just had a brain fade out there in the middle of the park. I don't know what's caused it, but, you know, you just can't do those type of things on a footy field.
And the fact there's a broken jaw, you could see when the runners went out to Brayshaw, they were saying, don't like this, his teeth were out. Not great at all.
As you mentioned, extremely uncharacteristic. 175 games without being suspended once. Andrew Gaff has fronted the media. He's spoken after the match.
Yeah, I just want to apologise to Andy, and I feel sick. I feel sick about it and did the wrong thing, and a lot of things it doesn't indicate my character and all that, but my main thought is how he is, and very remorseful and feel sick about it.
Well, you guys both know things happen on the footy field that you regret the heat of the moment and all that kind of stuff, and you've got to give credit to Gaff for coming out and sharing his emotions.
Yeah, look, he seems like a really good fella, but unfortunately, that there was a king hit. Yeah, you can't have that happening in any games of footy.
And it's funny, because, you know, you see you hit a guy in the stomach and you get weeks. You hit them in the chest, you probably don't get suspended. It's like, was he thinking, right, I'm going to hit him in the chest and he's gone too high and it's now going to cost him 6 weeks? Because a gut shot, you get 3. Yeah. Around this area, you sometimes get away. I don't know.